luck on your travels. No attacks, no disasters, no arrogance. It's been quite pleasant having Master Anders staying here, Monsieur.
He's funny.
And he farts by boys and chanting quite intriguing. That's the word he used. It's too bad he seems so intent on whatever it is he works on. Never know.
I've never seen another dwarf like him. Does this run in your family?
Not at all, but Sandal isn't really my son. I found him in the deep roads when I left Orzammar for good. Raised him as my own now. Isn't that right, my boy?
I like Bodan.
He's always been this way. Always collecting things and enchanting them. Strange, I suppose.
Have you ever thought of finding out more?
Well, I did. I brought him to the Circle of Magi about a year after we got to the surface. They called him a savant, but then they started giving him the eye like they were going to keep him, so he left. Not going back to those vultures. Sandal's happy as he is.
Sandal's quite useful to have around.
That he is, also, I've always said. Maker knows what will happen when I'm gone. I try not to think about it.
I want some pie.
Varric's taken it upon himself to add certain embellishments to my journal. Crude drawings in the margins. Isabella, grow up. What's this? Oh, Anders' manifesto. Again. What's this? Oh, Anders' manifesto. Again.
Thank you.
you're glaring, Anders. Is there a reason, or is it one of your moods?
Your term as captain hasn't been particularly mage-friendly.
I've only turned a handful over to the Templars.
Every despot starts somewhere.
And yet I allow an abomination to whine at me. Credit where it's due.
Like something you would say, Varric.
Me? I'm hurt you'd think I'd spread such a half-spun tale. I tell people how you arm wrestled a 100-foot-tall golem in the Deep Roads. Just don't be surprised if people seem in awe.
I find it hard to believe you're spreading these stories without getting something in return.
Well, that just shows what you know, Hawk. The stories are their own. You really need to see the look on someone's face when I tell them you ripped the arms off at Mulgar. Just once.
What compels you to spin these ridiculous tales?
I love the sound of my own voice. And I'm a compulsive liar. Honestly, I don't know. It's just something I do. There's power in stories, though. That's all history is. The best tales, the ones that last. Might as well be mine.
Stole from her. Distracted client. You're lucky she wasn't jailed.
My women? I am but a shepherd. And what free enterprise are you oppressing now?
Theft is not enterprise.
Opportunities insufficiently guarded. Victimless crimes. Except for the victims. Details. Victimless details.